Assalamu alaikum. You are watching Modest Muse in Review, the lifestyle show where we review what's in the current issue of Modest Muse Lifestyle Tabloid. We are back from the break from chatting with Abdul Hasib Jacobs from Lighthouse Therapeutic Community Drug Rehabilitation Center. I think I mixed it up, two of the words, but you get the gist. We are dealing with the topic of addiction, a very serious topic. We stopped off just before the break about chatting about how those who were previously addicted and who are in recovery for approximately 5 years can give back and go on to a program. Abdul Hasib, welcome back. So tell us more about how previous addicts who are in recovery can give back to the community and assist.
Yeah, I think that is very important. You know, people who are facing this disease of addiction, they have a lot also to give to communities, their experience, their journey. So they...
And that sense of purpose keeps them clean.
Yeah. So it's, you know, it's about, addiction's about feelings. People go to drugs because of feelings. I feel angry and I go to drugs. I don't know how to handle anger. I don't have the skill to overcome my feeling. But also happy feelings. They don't know how to cope with happy feelings. So it's about feelings. And they, when they are conducting and they are working with the client, then they know what they are talking about because they can feel what the client is feeling.
They can relate completely
because they feel. They went through that. Mm-hmm. They've been there. So for them to bring that person over is sometimes a bit easier because they will speak the same feeling and the same language.
And also for an addict who is still an addict, not in recovery, to look at this person, they kind of see them as a role model, someone to aspire to. I mean, because you've been clean for 5 years, I can get there too.
Yes, and if you can do it, and then so can I. So that is my new vision, where we would like to, the staff, the professional staff is there just to guide and to supervise, right? Clinical work, the staff will do. But when it comes to floor work, then those people who went through our program on recovery coaching, they will be the people to deal with the client on the floor.
So Abdul Hasib, can anybody who's been clean for a period of 5 years, can they approach you to go through this course of recovery coaching?
It's open to everybody.
They don't it doesn't necessarily have to be that they were at Lighthouse.
No.
Okay.
No. I welcome them. They must feel welcome just to contact me, and I'll put them in touch with the relevant people. So if we have enough people who wants to do the program, there are 8 modules,
okay,
right, on substance use disorder. Those are more for professional people like the social worker, the nurse, the doctor, the psychiatric nurse, etc. The recovery coaching is for people who are on recovery. If you are not on recovery, you can also do the recovery coaching, but you can't coach a person who you want to bring him into recovery, but you don't know what you're talking about. So that could give us even a greater success, inshallah. So if we have enough people, it's as simple as email Colombo plan. Mm-hmm. We have enough people to go onto this program, and then we have the
program. Is there a cost involved?
The cost is $100, and that is for registration. They are not paying for the course. No. The course we did in about 9 days.
That's not, I mean, for what they're going to go through and the amount of assistance they're going to offer. $100 is what, that's like R1,000? It's not a lot.
It's not a lot of money. And that is just for registration. That is your commitment to attend the program. Like I said, last year we had one. And if they are financially stable or the family can afford, these programs are being conducted all over the world. So it's going to be in Malacca this year. In I think it's going to be towards August. So those who are ready, all they need is they need the ticket money.
So there's an opportunity to travel as well, like you did to Singapore.
And get the certificate. So they can go to Malacca and do the course there. After that, it may just be in Pakistan or India, or they travel all over the world.
So what you're saying, Abdul Hasib, is that Lighthouse is not only a body of professionals that can assist addicts, but you've got people who have gone through this course, who are in recovery themselves, who have made it through the 5 years. So you've got a solid body of people to assist not only addicts, but to support the families going through this as well.
There is family programs.
Okay.
If we have enough families who are interested to do a family program, they would come down and they cover all the costs. The conference package, they covered over the past 3 years, I think came to like 300,000 rand. They covered it. They have different programs.
So I'm a mom. I have a family member, or I've got a child who is an addict. I don't know how to deal with it. Would my first point of contact be Lighthouse?
Yeah, I think what is also very important is sometimes we are spending a lot of time on the person that is in addiction.
Yeah.
And that person may not be ready to go into treatment. Mm. But what happens to the family?
They crumble all around us, yeah.
They crumble, and how can you fight a battle and this big war if you are weak? So what is very important is get help for yourself first.
So you are
strong enough, and you are empowered, you have the understanding of how to deal with a person that needs help.
And Lighthouse offers that help.
We offer that, especially on the Tuesday evening. We have a support group meeting. And that is only for parents who have this addiction problem at home. Where we deal with parents and try to empower them how to assist the person who needs recovery.
Now there's this thinking or feeling that addiction is a problem of the lower LSM communities because of poverty, so people turn to drugs and a life of crime. But me being in the media industry and chatting to a lot of women, I see that it's happening. It's more rife in the affluent areas as well, because these addicts now, they've got access to money, they've got access to businesses, and they are hitting the harder drugs sooner.
That is so correct. The difference would possibly be that those who are affluent, they have the money, they can go to cocaine, heroin, and those who are not so affluent, they would start stealing to support the habit, get into criminal activity to support the habit.
But what I'm seeing is addiction doesn't know an income group. It's hitting
no race, no income group.
No sex.
Yeah. If you want the high, everything is over. You know, it is today. It's about if the need is there, the supply is there.
I like what you said earlier about the no judgment, because Islam says don't intoxicate your body. So automatically when you meet someone who's an addict, whether they're addicted to alcohol or substances, you automatically judge, like, where's your iman? And this is why women don't speak about what's happening in their homes, because people are going to judge me. I'm going to judge my child that I didn't bring them up properly. The iman's not strong enough. But it's actually not that. Like you're saying, it's a disease. This a disease of feelings. This person is trying to either escape reality or can't deal, so let's not judge, let's help.
And also, you know, the peer pressure, we made many mistakes in our lives, right? Opening up a business and then it doesn't work. But because you didn't know. So sometimes people go and experiment, not realizing young people and even matured people, business people, they go doctors. They go, for example, one of my clients was a medical person, and He had to do, I think, surgery over, I don't know how many hours. And somebody told him, you know, if you take this drug, it keeps you awake, it keeps you alert.
And focused.
And not realizing, if I touch it, I can be whooped.
Mm. Shukran so much, Abdul Hasib. A very hard topic to speak about, but it's very enlightening to speak to you about it. Our viewers can, Abdul Hasib's details are at the bottom of the screen. Please do contact him, contact Lighthouse, offer your help, offer your support. And if you're in need, please do contact him. Shukran, join me in studio next week where I have some more phenomenal guests.